every service in this city is going to be impacted.
So the fake news in the mainstream media is basically downplaying this migrant crisis. You know what I'm saying? They reporting it, and then, but yo, this is the biggest problem that faces America at this point in time. And this is being pushed on us by the liberal Democrats, and it's basically nothing nobody can do because of their positions. So this migrant crisis is basically the George Soros open border initiative globally, and they actually pushing it on America, because once they destroy America borders, they could destroy the borders all over the world. So all of this Trump warned us about when he was trying to build the wall, because he already knew the Democrats' plans, the liberals' plans, and what was going to happen. So we failed to build the wall because they stopped the wall. And then now we're dealing with this crisis, which is purposely being done. So as you're going to discover, these are not migrants. These are criminals. These are illegal immigrants. They put in migrants. They're illegal immigrants and they're criminals. When I say criminals, I don't mean just because they crossed our border illegally. Not only that, these are criminals. And from their country, they're criminals. So all the criminals was released from jail and was said, if you go to America, you get there. All criminals took their families, everybody, and they're here to do crime.
A hit for people to go do his dirty work, to grab phones and stuff. So.
Great job. Everything was handled. Everybody left safe. And we put bad guys in jail.
This is a scene right outside the Roosevelt Hotel in New York City. Due to the hotel being at maximum capacity, Mayor Eric Adams has decided to relocate hundreds of migrants to the city streets. This situation shows just how poorly Democrats run their cities.
So the puppet Eric Adams used this to get in office, say, yeah, we're going to welcome the migrants. So he got all the liberal Democrats to back him in becoming mayor. So when they heard Eric Adams' campaign, they said, yeah, this is our guy. So they made sure Eric Adams win. And then once Eric Adams was mayor, he realized that, oh my God, there's no way that the city can sustain this. He stood against the migrants. And guess what they did to him? They went after Eric Adams for illegal campaign funds. All the way this far down the line in his campaign. And they did it while he was on his way to Washington, D.C., forcing him to turn the limousine around. And now Eric Adams is back in line with the migrants, giving them money. So listen what Eric Adams was saying before the liberals went on an all-out assault on him.
This issue will destroy New York City. Destroy New York City. We're getting 10,000 migrants a month. One time we were just getting Venezuela. Now we're getting Ecuador. Now we're getting Russian speaking coming through Mexico. Now we're getting Western Africa. Now we're getting people from all over the globe have made their minds up that they're going to come through the southern part of the border and come into New York City. And everyone is saying it's New York City's problem. Every community in this city is going to be impacted. We got a $12 billion deficit that we're going to have to cut. Every service in this city is going to be impacted.
So Eric Adams went on an anti-migrant tour for about 2 to 3 months. Oh, the liberals ain't having that. And they will show you, Eric Adams, they're going to treat you just like they treat Donald Trump. Bring up bogus charges against you, and now voila, those charges all disappeared. Now that Eric Adams is back on track. So let's listen to what happened to Eric Adams and his consultant.
Your campaign consultant of Eric Adams had her house raided by the FBI today. National correspondent Bill Malugin with more.
Rachel, that's right. FBI agents raided the home of New York City Mayor Eric Adams' chief fundraiser today. That then led Adams to cancel several meetings he had planned in D.C. today. According to the New York Times, the FBI served a search warrant at the Brooklyn home of Breonna Suggs. She's a campaign consultant for Mayor Adams, who was deeply involved in his campaign. The Times reports that according to the search warrants they obtained, the raid was part of a broad public corruption probe looking into whether or not Adams' 2021 mayoral campaign conspired with a Brooklyn construction company and the Turkish government to funnel foreign money into the campaign's coffers through a straw donor scheme. According to the Times, investigators are particularly interested in finding out whether or not Adams' campaign kicked back any benefits to the construction company's officials and employees, as well as any Turkish officials. Now, the Times reports the warrants make it unclear if the investigation is actually targeting Mayor Adams himself. However, he did cancel several meetings in Washington this morning, including a meeting with the White House to ask for more federal money to help with a surge of migrant arrivals in his sanctuary city.
So look how nasty and complex the liberal is. So Eric Adams posts this video right here talking about how he's going to D.C. and he's going to talk about the migrants and all of this and that. And, you know, because he don't want all these migrants coming to the city because it's unmanageable. And they said, oh, yeah, you're going to post this video? So the White House immediately called the feds and said, that case y'all got against Adams, push it. So they go raid his consulting house as he traveled to D.C., forcing him to turn the limousine around. So listen to Adams tell you, it don't sound nothing like what the news was just telling you that he was going there to discuss. He's going there to discuss, why the hell are these fucking migrants coming to my city like this? There's no way this is sustainable.
The White House. We headed to D.C. to meet with our congressional delegation and the White House to address this real issue of the asylum and migrant issue in our city, and we'll keep you updated as the day goes.
We believe the borders should remain open. That's the official position of this city, but we have made it clear there should be a decompression strategy that we could properly deal with the volumes that's coming into our city, and no cities should have to carry the burden of
the national
government.
I bet he won't be repeating those words again. Now look at this.
It's raided by federal agents with multiple devices seized. This series of events led to the postponement of Adams' prearranged visit to discuss the migrant crisis in New York City. Adams expressed solidarity with his campaign crew and Suggs, emphasizing her traumatic experience. The ongoing.
So just like that, Eric Adams is back in the liberals' pocket and playing the liberals' game. So now the migrants can vote in New York City. The migrants is about to get free credit cards in New York City. Fuck a welfare card. They're about to get free credit cards. The migrants. So this is why blacks is not voting for Biden and the Democrats no more. America will turn red, but the Democrats' plan is to get all these illegal aliens here, break all norms and rules, and have illegal migrants vote. They're going to start trying to say, yeah, they can just only vote in the congressional districts, and then they're going to move it into the presidential campaigns. And then, at the same time, they're going to use the migrants to try to spike up the economy. This is like a psychopath madman plan that's gonna backfire. These people are thieves and criminals, and they're gonna steal more, and you're gonna give them more, and then half of the money and the stuff that they loot from America, they're gonna send back home to their countries, to their families. So this is wicked, because they're spending your money on there, and then they're gonna spend your future tax money on that, because they're gonna raise your taxes to cover these tabs. And they know they're not gonna be in the White House next year, so they trying to run it up so the next administration, which hopefully will be Trump, he ain't gonna be able to do nothing, because they're gonna create so much debt. So much mismanagement of government. Trump ain't gonna be able to do nothing next term. Nobody ain't gonna be able to do nothing. So everybody win. All American enemies win. China, Soros, and deliverers that seek to destroy America, because they're going to inflate the American dollar. The American dollar going to be so inflated, hyperinflated from wars, from migration crises, that we're going to be forced to one world currency,